Blue told me, remind you niggas. Fuck that shit y'all talking about. I'm the nigga.
Thank you. And a new super middleweight champion of the world.
Taylor, man, I still love you. Send me fight, my man. Is it one of those videos you were in? It don't mean nothing.
Yeah, man put one up too.
Yeah, no, I saw.
Yeah, And the other kid, the black kid put one up of getting that Caleb. Assassination Nation.
How you feel, champ?
Oh, good, man. Just staying loose.
Staying loose, huh?
Yeah.
Staying in the gym. You live in the gym.
Oh yeah, this is my. Hey, if I live in the gym, I'll probably kill somebody. When the quarantine was happening, I was losing my damn mind.
I bet.
I'm like, damn.
Especially when everything was initially shut down.
Yeah.
Oh man.
I was. So you know, now I just had the biggest win of my career. I just beat the boogeyman in my division.
Right.
So we just staying ready. Like,
any word on anything, or you just?
We working on something.
Working on something.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, something big. I ain't. You won't see me fighting on nothing small no more.
Right. Right.
Like, you know, it's over.
They gotta respect you though.
They got to. Like, remember, we did the interview before, and I was like, "You gonna fight who's? I hope he fight me." And,
right.
And, you know what I mean? So we spoke that up.
Yeah, we did.
You know what I mean?
Oh. We still gotta get that belt. We spoke that up too.
Belt. That belt definitely. Listen, I don't care who I fight. Like, I'm the best. Like I said on Showtime, I'm the best kept secret in boxing. Well, I ain't a secret no more.
Right.
But I'm the best super middleweight on the planet. Like, you know what I mean? Like, not just in the world. If you go to Venus, Mars, and we'll find a super middleweight belt.
Facts.
And the powers that be know it. They know what it Teggy fight, we got it late. He knew he was fighting me before I knew I was fighting him. We had like 2 weeks and a half, maybe three. Well, I don't want to lie.
But they didn't know you stay ready.
You're right. And then they sunk me down the weight to 168. So that was really a death trap. But it's just I'm so incredibly good that we sparred one time. A southpaw.
Okay.
I'm just so good that it really don't. I mean, so now I think I earned the right to have time to prepare properly.
Well, how do you feel about with Benavidez losing the belt? So clearly that's not going to be a big fight with him and Khalil Plant. So you think they should just respect you and throw you in? Or how do you feel about that?
Oh, yeah. Like I said, it don't matter to me who I fight at 68. Like, I don't care as long as the money is right. I think I earned the right to make some money. The other fighters is making tons of money fighting bums. I'm in tough fight back to back. and barely got enough money to get me through 6 months. And I'm dominating these guys, like, easy. Like, I think I earned the right to make some money and buy a house and live a good lifestyle. I think I earned that right.
Exactly.
So, you know, I'm not getting in the ring until I get paid properly. Like Jay-Z said in the rap, he said, you know niggas die for equal pay, right? You know when I work, I ain't your slave, right? You know I ain't with the high five and jucking and jiving. You know this ain't back in the day, right? You know what I'm saying? That's how I'm feeling right now. Like,
right,
you know,
right.
Put some respect on my name. I know I'm not the chosen one to win, but when you win, you're supposed to get rewarded, right?
I mean, let's be honest. You fight one fight before Caleb Plant, you had a belt.
Oh, yeah.
So.
Yeah. Exactly.
I'd be champion right now.
Be world champion right now.
So.
And if you look at it, you see, it ain't that I beat him. It's how easy I beat him. Like,
You look good.
And mind you, I wasn't even really prepared, and I tore my labrum in the fight. Like, if that didn't happen, I would have stopped him. Like, you know what I'm saying? I had him hurt a few times. You know what I'm saying? I just couldn't turn up because my shoulder was killing me. But, like, I beat him easy with 3 weeks at the most. You know what I mean? A world champion.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like you just said, you made a good point. If I fought him a fight earlier, I'd be world champion.
Right now.
World champion right now.
Right.
With easy, though. Like, right. Easy. You know what I mean?
But to jump on that point real quick, that you're right. They need to respect you. At this point, you need to be paid.
Yeah. I got a lot of good fights I can get the fans, but I got to get paid. Like, everybody else getting paid. Like, everybody else can turn down fights when the money ain't right, except for me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, no, I think I earned the right to make some money.
I agree.
So that's what, they come back with the money, any super middleweight can get it. I don't care who it is. Like, I really don't care who it is. He do a lot of tricky stuff, so I had to be on point.
Right.
So, but it shows you how good I am. You know what I'm saying? Like they're doing it. If him and David, if he'd have beat me, right, he'd have fought Caleb or David. But they was building up a big fight for him and David Benavidez. That's what they was trying to do. Like, and they was going to make, both of them was going to make money.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So now that I beat him, I deserve to get that money.
So I'm saying, they need to throw your name in the hat.
Yeah.
At this point.
Like, everybody still talking about some. Who's to take it? I was talking about, yo, they act like he ain't just get destroyed. Like, you know what I'm saying? stand ready. Like,
I think you should be next for the WBC. Like,
yeah.
I don't know who they're gonna line up for that belt, so I'm just wondering what they're gonna say.
I would love to fight even Canelo.
Right.
Like, I'm ready. Like, I'm gonna shock the world. Well, I'm not gonna shock myself, but.
Right.
Cause I just don't. A lot of these super middleweights, it's easy to be world champion when you got a lot of support. But this to me is other guys, I fought my way to the top of the mountain.
Right.
They took a helicopter to the top of the mountain.
Right.
I had to really take each climb, fall back down, climb back up. Different animal, you know what I mean? So, like, I don't fight these guys, it's really battle tested.
Champ, let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Do you feel like, see, I know what type of brother you are. So
yeah.
Do you feel like you being humble, like it's almost like the you need to just start calling people out at this point? I mean, to get the paid and get the fights, because being humble is okay, but
yeah.
You know, now it's time to earn the respect. So yeah. Now let's get this money, let's get these belts, let's get a shot.
Well, I feel like this. Like, I talk when I need to. Like, if you watch the press conference of Usategi, you see I didn't back down when he came at me, I came back at him. Like, I'm really not unless I know what's gonna happen, I'm not the one to talk a whole bunch of shit and just look crazy on social media. Like, you see all these fighters, those fights never happen. You gotta realize it's politics. They got a plan for their fighter. It's politics. So, like, me talking shit, what's that really gonna do? Like, the people can wanna see it all they want, but the politics of boxing is what runs boxing. So it's like, I feel like with that win, that was all the talking I needed to do. Like, they seen what I can do. Anybody who know me know I'm willing to fight whoever. All I'm asking is be fair with the money. That's all I'm asking for. Like, you know what I mean? Like, if these guys are so good, let's go. I know I can beat all of them. I don't think I know I can beat all of them. So it's like, just get the money right. Like, right. I ain't trying to be no broke world champion.
Right, right.
Be world champion still living in an apartment.
Right.
You know what I mean? Barely can afford a car. You know what I mean? Like, the object is to, when you're the best, you get paid for it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I never just go. And all the champions know me. They know what it is. And if they don't, they can find out.
Right.
You know, I'm listening. You talk about my age, you 35. Listen, to my age show in the ring, don't bring my age up.
Okay, so to get it on record, with you not having a belt, would you be willing to travel? Well, I already know the answer, but would you be willing to travel?
Yep. Mm-hmm. The money, right? Shit's about getting paid. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I just don't believe in this. I don't believe I'm gonna lose no fights at this weight. I just, look at what I did at light heavy against good guys, guys that can punch, guys that fought for world titles. And I really beat those guys. I just didn't get the decision. Like, they split decision losses, and you can look this up. Yeah. I only really one loss. And Edwin Rodriguez, that one could have went either way, but that's somebody that's 10 times bigger than me. Came in 5 pounds overweight, and the fight was still close.
Right, I was at the fight.
You know what I'm saying? So these guys, like, and now I got a nutritionist for making a weight cut and all that. I ain't worried. Whoever won't. Don't matter. And I got Chris too. Don't matter.
Chris putting in that work.
Nice.
Today. Yeah. A lot of time.
champ. I think you beat Billy Joe Saunders.
Oh yeah. For the W. It'd be a good fight though. He
I'd love to see that fight too.
Which one? Billy Joe Saunders.
Oh yeah.
He's slick. Like he's slick like me.
Boxer.
Yeah, he's slick. He like that. I would love that fight.
I just gotta pass it. Sport test.
Yeah.
Right.
Right. It's crazy because I got randomly drug tested a couple weeks ago.
I seen that. You put it on IG.
Here's my thing. I've never been caught cheating.
Right.
I never even cheated. I never been caught for nothing.
Right.
Like, you know what I'm saying? So, like, how come they on me so hard about it? I don't mind.
It would almost seem like they wanted you to pop dirty. And then, you know, that'll throw away your opportunity. Almost
or take away the Mr. Teggy win.
Right, right.
I'm like, listen, I'm honorable. Death before dishonor all the way with me.
Right.
I don't just talk it. See, boxing is cool, being world champion is cool. This for me and other fighters is that I'm really the person that I say I am. I'm really the person I say I am. You know what I'm saying? A lot of these fighters are frauds, for real. They be cheating, talking about I'm a world champion. If you got to cheat, no, you're not. Right. If you got to take anything to beat another man when this sport is already dangerous and look in the mirror and be satisfied with yourself, you a piece of shit and you're a fraud. You a fraud. Like, and that's why I'm willing to fight any world champions. Like, these guys got so much other stuff that goes into them being a world champion. Me, I just fight. All the bullshit, all the Instagram likes, I don't care about none of that. I don't care about none of that shit. When we get in that ring one-on-one, it's home. Mm. It's home. I'm the baddest 2 middleweight, like I said, on the planet. Go to Venus, Mars. You won't find an alien 2 middleweight that's better than me. Maybe stronger. But.
Supposedly, how you feel about Mr. Gary Russell? He didn't take the contract.
Gary Russell's a beast. That's my listen.
He doesn't want to fight Devin.
He don't?
Nope.
But he ain't signed it?
Nope.
Nah.
I'm gonna go back and check my records, but I was getting all these texts and I got a few little IG posts sent to me saying Mr. Gary Russell denied the contract to fight Devin.
That's big, cause Gary Russell, that's my guy. Devin Haney is too. Like,
but like I said, I'm gonna go back and check. I'm gonna go back and check my facts. But like I said, I woke up and I got all this stuff. I'm like
you can't do all that talking on Instagram and then not fight.
Right.
Like you just can't do that. Like you know what I'm saying? Like Devin Haney's my guy. Gary Russell, I'm real cool with both of them. I just wanted to see the fight. I thought it was gonna be a good fight.
I thought so too.
Like you know what I'm saying? Like it's one of the fights where it's like a toss up. It's like they both good as hell. So you know what I mean? I just wanted to see it. Like I hope like we can get that fight.
Yeah.
I hope we can get it.
I got an appointment for the car service.
Okay, go ahead. just hit the back.
Good work.
All right. That was just a 5 and 6, I think.
Okay. You know, I'm comfortable around.
I know. You just count how tired I am. That's how we do it.
Yeah.
Let me get your prediction. Errol Spence and Danny Garcia, how you feel?
Danny Garcia always got that bomb. That. He always got that bomb. Errol Spence, well-rounded fighter, complete fighter. If I'm going on skills, I'm going with Errol Spence. You can never count Danny out though, because he gets you with that bomb. I think he got enough to put anybody down.
Now, I hear a lot of people keep saying the same thing, and they keep talking about, they don't even talk about the skills, they just keep talking about the car accident. How do you feel about that, as far as that playing a role in the fight?
It all depends how good his therapy was.
Because I'm pretty sure he's been sparring. He's been sparring with the Charlo twins, so I know the chin has been checked.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he's been hit, so.
I thank you, but the real thing is.
All right, Chris.
Like a fight. The fight is totally different. A lot more on the line. Jitters, nervous, littler gloves, no hick. It's a little different. And then when they get faster, you know what I mean? So I'm going with Spence. Like, but if he gets caught, it's that left hook.
Right, right.
You know, like, you know what I mean? I got to lean more towards Spence. But it's a phenomenal fight.
Absolutely.
I think y'all like it.
I wouldn't be shocked if...
Garcia win.
No, I just wouldn't be shocked if... I think Spence might take this easy. Uh-huh. And I think he's going to outbox him and just stay on the outside. I don't think he... I think we're going to see a different Spence.
But my thing is that sometimes certain people get up for certain people.
Facts.
Nobody thought Buster Douglas was going to beat Mike Tyson.
Right.
Some people were like, I'm like that. Like, I get up for certain... I get up for the big fights. Like... When it's a fight, people think I'm gonna win, I get up. I say, okay. Like, I get up. So, some people like that, so you never know what guy will show up.
Right.
So you guys prepare for anything. You know what I mean? Like.
How do you feel with the pandemic, though, as far as boxing without a crowd? Does that take it out for you? Does it make you, you know what I mean? Because some fighters think different
it's
things.
It's not like winning and hopping on the ropes, like everybody in the ring screaming. Like, you live for that. That's what you live for. That's what I live for. Walking down the aisle, the camera's all in your face, and the entrance way, and then everybody like shake, pulling their hand out, and like, you know, then you look up and you're in the big lights, and everybody, you see the crowd, you're like, this is where this is, it's time, you know what I mean? That's what I live for. So it's kind of like, you got to mentally prepare yourself, because it's like sparring. It's like a high level sparring match, you know what I mean?
Right.
So it's like, without the crowd, I can't wait till all this is over, man, so the crowd can come back. And,
right.
You know what I mean? Because I'm ready. Now, I Usategi, I love hearing people talk. Like, yeah, do this, do that. I'm aware of everything around me. Like, I live for that shit.
Right. your boy Real Deal Boxing Talk. I'm with Lionel Thompson, super middleweight. Anything you want to say to the people?
Yeah, man. Y'all see me in the ring again real soon. I will be super middleweight champ of the world. Undisputed super middleweight champ of the world that ever get to happen. So many sanctioning bodies. I would love to be super middleweight champ of the world. I'm looking for all the smoke with any super middleweight. Y'all can pick who y'all want to see me fight next. Gotta be somebody good in the top 10 though. And I'm willing to prove I ain't just a fighter that talks shit. Like, I'm really about that action. Like, so, you know, thank you guys for supporting me. The guys that secretly hate me, the guys that love me, the guys that support me, the guys that fake support me. I love all y'all. You know, y'all gonna be seeing a lot more from Lonnie B.